The force of the seals and whatever is inside the suspension, it holds everything together. So when you push the bike down, it should go easy down, but it doesn't. Look how much force I have to add before it starts moving. And now it starts moving. So I'm talking 20 to 30 pounds. Okay, so the suspension is completely decompressed. Let me add 15 pounds, see if it's gonna make a difference. 15 pounds, no difference. Let's see. At 10 kilograms, 20 pounds. Before 20 pounds, nothing happens. Took the fork out. I took a spacer out. So this was the last spacer that was in here. So right now the spring is literally just barely being held by the cap. So there's no play in the spring, which is very, very important, but also the spring has just enough tension to keep the cap up. So the spring is not too long, and that's good. This is the part that bothers me. So I have a complete rebuilt kit with new seals, new bushings, new everything. And if you put the wheel fork down and you lift it up, you see, the seal is snug enough on the tube. It just doesn't let it travel. So I'm gonna take the other one out, but look, see if I move this is just the seal, there's no spring right now. And if I leave the weight on it, it just, look how much binding there is in here. The seal is so snug, and either the bushing or something is just making it so snug, it just doesn't travel. And it drives me nuts. So this is the second fork, same exact story. It's all the way up, and look, it's not traveling at all. And for those people saying that no, it's not this. It has no grip. So because it was driving me nuts, I took the entire fork off, and I did find this little ring was a little bit bent, but it was bent because when I split them open, it puts a lot of force on it. So I'm gonna put one of these new in there, but this one doesn't really affect the way that the fork slides. These are the bushings, and I'm gonna test the bushings in a second, but I wanna show you something real quick, guys. So on the fork, you have two rings, right? You have the seal, and then you have the we could take this one off right now. So you have the seal, and then you have the dust seal. So this one requires about maybe 3 pounds of force to push down. Like, it has a little initial resistance, and then it starts moving. But the oil seal, well, this one, even with oil on the fork, because there is oil right now on the fork, this one needs about, I want to estimate, like, I don't know, maybe 5 pounds, maybe more, just to move. Yeah, it needs at least 3 pounds. So you have about 2 pounds over here, and then 3 pounds over here just to move. And that's the snag that I feel in the fork. But I can't fix that because the seal is a seal, right? I also was talking to Mr. Duffactor, which is a suspension guru from Salt Lake. I'm going to put a link for his stuff in the bottom of the video description. He was telling me to check the bushings and see how they play inside this entire fork system. So we have this ring that goes here. Then we have one bushing that goes over, and then this bushing goes over here. These are brand new bushings that I just put in, right? And then the fork goes this way. Now, he was telling me a very, very valid point. It's something that I should watch for. Right now, when you assemble it, you see this bushing over here? This is usually driven in by this ring, and then it's driven by the seal when you knock them in place. But that could be a problem because you could damage the ring and other stuff in there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drive this seal first, no, this bushing first, and then try the suspension without the seal ring in there. So I'm going to push this one in first, and then see how it's going to feel that way. Without the seal itself. See, there's a snag in the suspension. So right now, let's see how much free movement we have on this. So there is absolutely no snag on it. This suspension moves super smooth on the bushings themselves. So it's super smooth on the bushings themselves. A couple of days later, the bike is back together. Everything is working as it worked before. No improvement. I have a little bit of a snag on the front. It's really, really annoying. For those people that want to ask me, did you mount the front wheel properly and you release the pressure of the forks? Yes, I've done that. Did I check the seal savers not to create the snag? Yes. Did I check the bushings? Yes. Do I have oil in it? Yes. So I've checked basically everything. I went through the box and checked everything except one thing.
And this is maybe the most important part of the information that you're going to get into this video. Supposedly, there are like some special seals called SKF, or the brand SKF. Smooth as butter. Sold a little bit more expensive than OEM, because I tried OEM and I tried all balls on this one. So next time, I'm going to rebuild the suspension, which is okay right now. If I'm going to keep the bike, I'm going to buy the SKF. I might even buy them before and just throw them in there and just give it a try. So you might want to subscribe to the channel, because I'm going to give it a try to the SKF to see if there's if that's what's going to make the difference between where it was before and what it is right now. Because right now, even though these are new seals and are not very, very worn, they're very, very annoying, because you have that little snag right in the beginning. So everything that is small, like any small rocks or anything like that, it just hits crazy, and then it's super smooth on the heavy stuff. So the suspension definitely works. It's just that it doesn't take those little rocks out of the handlebar. You can feel every little rock, you know, because it just doesn't move at low impact. So let's see where we're going to go. Stay subscribed to the channel. I'm going to try the SKF next, and hopefully that's going to solve my problem and maybe yours. Vegas Romaniac out.